Hey everyone, what's going on? This is Rob here. Welcome back to the channel. In this video, it's just going to be a very short and sweet explanation of ProxyARP. So if you look at this diagram right here, we have a router and we have two different subnets. So each of these are a /27. So we have 172.16.1.0/27. And over here we have 172.16.1.32/27. Okay, this router is connected to two switches, a layer two switch on each side, and then we have a PC coming off of each switch. So this PC is configured properly. It has an IP address of 172.16.1.10 with a subnet mask of 255.255.255.224. So this PC would be in this network. Its default gateway will be the .1, so 172.16.1.1. And over here on the 172.16.1.32/27 network, we have a default gateway of .33. So 172.16.1.33 would be the default gateway for PC2. But do you see the problem here is that this PC, 172.16.1.40, is actually configured with the wrong subnet mask. So this is configured with a /24. What is the issue there? Well, the issue there is, say that PC2 wanted to communicate with PC1. Well, naturally, if this was configured correctly, PC2 would ARP for the default gateway for its layer 2 address, so its MAC address, if it didn't already have it, and then it would forward that traffic out of its network interface over to the router, and then the router would route it over here. Well, since this is a /24, it thinks that PC1, 172.16.1.10, is actually on the same network. So it's going to ARP for it. Well, it's not connected to switch 2. It's over here on this other side of the router on a different subnet. So this is where ProxyARP comes into play if it's configured on your router. Now, this isn't the right way that it's supposed to work, obviously. It is kind of a mechanism specifically for this, if you have devices with misconfigured subnet masks or default gateways and that sort of thing. But if ProxyARP is enabled on this router, PC2 is going to naturally ARP for 172.16.1.10 because it thinks it's on the same subnet. That ARP is broadcasted, so it's going to arrive on this interface on this router, and the router is going to say, hey, I'm not 172.16.1.10, but I know how to get there. So the router will respond with its MAC address, send that back to PC2, and then if you look at the ARP cache in PC2, it'll actually have the MAC address for 172.16.1.10, and it will be the MAC address of the interface on this router. So PC2 will then forward that to the router, thinking that it's actually forwarding it at layer 2 to 172.16.1.10, and the router will deliver it to the destination. Now on this side, since routing is set up properly, this is on the subnet mask is configured appropriately, return traffic will be routed back just the way it should. So that is ProxyARP in a nutshell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.